Hello, and welcome to our session on developers in Africa. Africa's startups are going through a period of unprecedented growth, reaching new funding heights each year. But what does this mean for the developers behind the startups? Today, we're going to share insights from our research in Africa, the data and the people behind Africa's startup ecosystem. I'm John Kimani from Google's developer ecosystem team in sub-Saharan Africa. My team works with developers who are leveraging Google's technologies to build innovative solutions for Africa and the world. We support developers through a number of community programs, such as Google Developer Groups and Student Clubs, which enable them to connect, learn, and grow together. We encourage you to join these communities at developers.google.com/community. These communities and programs exist in an ecosystem that is young and growing fast. To tell us more about this ecosystem, here's my colleague, Andy.
Thank you, John. I'm Andy Volk, and I lead the developer ecosystem team for Sub-Saharan Africa at Google. And I've spent the last decade focused on enabling African developers and startups to succeed. We're here today in partnership with Google's Next Billion Users team, which focuses on making technology helpful, relevant, and inclusive for people new to the internet. For Google, it's critical to look at both the direct results of our work with developers in the region and how it impacts Africa's developer ecosystem as a whole. As global policy expert Joni Seeger said, measurement counts. What gets counted, counts. And when it's not counted, it's absent and invisible. And so to understand our developer ecosystem impact, we need hard data. While there are multiple reports on Pan-African startup funding, in-depth research on Africa's developer talent landscape has been almost non-existent. So we partnered with Accenture and built Africa's first developer ecosystem report, which was published in 2020. Today, we want to share with you our newest 2021 version of the Africa Developer Ecosystem Report. This report is a result of a year of research with Accenture. We've measured the developer ecosystems of 16 different African countries across several different growth trajectories, from the countries maintaining steady growth to the ones sprinting ahead with high growth rates, to those building the foundation for future growth. Francophone and Lusophone country coverage also increased significantly in this report from the previous version, adding more linguistic diversity to our coverage. And here's our key message for you. The demand for African developers hit an all-time high last year. Can you guess why? To help answer that question, we're going to share insights with you on what's driving this rapidly increasing demand for African developers. We will share the reasons why developer opportunities across the continent are increasing. We'll also detail the positive effects of new demand on developer population and pay. Finally, we'll touch on some challenges and explain the role that education and access will have in ensuring growth for current and future generations of Africa's developer talent.
Thank you, Andy. Let's dive into the insights. Starting off with the increasing opportunity for African developers driven primarily by startups and small businesses. Demand for African developers continued to grow and reached new heights in 2021. Employers, both local and global, are creating opportunities for developers in Africa, allowing them to use their skills in building for Africa and the world. As for what's driving this growth, we believe that there are three main factors which contributed to this positive trend in 2021. Local startups raising more funding, increased global demand for remote tech talent, and increased internet usage by local businesses. Let's take a deeper look at each one of these factors. Looking at developer growth, we found a direct correlation between startup investment growth and developer growth in Africa. 2021 was a year of significant growth for startups in Africa. African startups raised over $4 billion in 2021, growing by over 150% in 2021 from the previous year and reaching yet another all-time annual funding peak. Our research shows that startups hire over half of Africa's developer population. Startups are often the first businesses willing to hire junior developers, providing critical on-the-job training. As you can see here, More than 80% of venture capital funding in Africa went to the top four countries with the highest population of software developers. That is Nigeria, South Africa, Egypt, and Kenya. During the COVID-19 pandemic, the percentage of global engineering teams working remotely increased over 5 times, and the majority of these teams are expected to stay remote after the pandemic. This trend points to continued remote work demand for developers in Africa. Local businesses increased internet use and hired developers to help them build their businesses online. An example is Ahadi Movers, a moving and relocation company based in Nairobi, Kenya, who grew the successful business from scratch with Google Business Profiles and Google Ads. They continue to expand, hiring more team members and serving between 70 and 100 customers a month.
The next batch of insights that we want to share with you are around Africa's developer ecosystem, its increased developer population, compensation, and preferred platforms. As we dive into the numbers showing how the size of Africa's developer population and pay grew in 2021, it's also important that we consider them in context of the fast-growing opportunity for African developers, which John just reviewed. According to our research in 2021, there were a total of 716,000 software developers in Africa. That represents nearly 4% growth compared to the previous year. But at the same time, as John shared with us, African startup funding increased 150%. To put things in perspective, although the number of developers continues to increase, that percentage is still smaller than how fast African startup funding and remote work opportunities for African developers have increased over the past year. Not surprisingly, in that same year, developer compensation increased by 9% for mid-level developers and 11% for senior-level developers. And if you want to see where these developers are investing most of their time, web and mobile development were the primary platform choices for developers in Africa, with nearly half of all developers building apps for Android, alongside the same number of developers building web-based solutions and applications. A third key takeaway we want to share with you is how education and access are driving developer growth. With increasing demand for African developers outpacing supply, it's critical that we look at how to best support the growth of Africa's developer ecosystem, both in terms of what's already working and what developers are telling us they need. When looking at the educational channels that developers are using for training, universities remain the number one single source of education for African software developers. However, more than half of developers learn through a variety of informal methods. These include boot camps, online coding schools, self-taught developers, and on-the-job training. In addition to looking at how developers are already learning and upskilling, we need to look at what headwinds developers are encountering in Africa and where we can improve their experience. When we asked these developers how their experience could be improved, the majority of responses fell into two groups. The top group of challenges were around internet access, specifically around speed, reliability, and cost. A second area of challenges were around developer education. They want more training opportunities right now. Specifically, they want more scholarships for training classes, networking events focused on upskilling and business connections, and in-person local learning events. Communities have also played a key role in supporting the growth of developer ecosystems worldwide. And that effect is just as strong in Africa, where Google reached nearly 1 out of every 2 developers on the African continent through our developer community and training programs, including Google Developer Groups, or GDGs.
A good example of developers coming together to learn and share is Google Developer Group Conakry in Guinea. Founded in 2018, GDG Conakry has grown to a community of 3,000 members who focus on machine learning and Android apps development. 2 years ago, the community introduced Google Technologies Week, a week-long series of tech talks focused on various Google technologies as a way of keeping the community's members engaged during the pandemic. Following the success of the debut event, they decided to make this event series a core part of their regular community offerings. The community's training and mentorship programs continue to provide inspiration for young people in Guinea looking to explore careers in software development.
To sum it up, in 2021 we've seen, Local and remote opportunities for African developers are growing rapidly. Africa's pool of professional developers continues to grow, but not as quickly as demand, resulting in higher compensation. And increased educational opportunities for developers, both formal and informal, are enabling the growth of developers in Africa. But there's still more that can be done to address developers' needs in Africa. We encourage you to download the full report at nextbillionusers.google under the Research tab. As mentioned at the beginning, Google's Next Billion Users initiative aims to create a more inclusive internet for everyone, everywhere. And we invite you to watch the other MBU sessions at Google I/O, what we can learn from the internet's newest users, and building for everyone, the importance of representative data, on demand at the I/O website under the MBU tag. Thank you for joining us today, and we're looking forward to seeing how you use the insights and the data from this report.
A special thank you to all the African startup founders and developers who give their time for this session.